Lots of MMOs are on consoles now. Good. The more varieties of games we get, the better. And the latest on the chopping block is Terra. On the surface, Terra is quite similar to other MMOs. You have a big world, quests, loot, and levels. But Terra's secret behind its flashes coat is an action-based combat system. None of this tab-targeting hotkey shite, which only worked in WoW because it was based on a strategy game. But then every next MMO copied it without thinking, oh, maybe not everyone likes this kind of combat system. 90% of what you do in an MMO is combat, and it always baffles me when they choose to make it shit. But thankfully, Terra's is good. It works pretty simply. Aim your reticle at the monster you want to twat, and then unleash your skills on it, many of which can be linked into combos, but some of them lock you into an animation, so you better make sure you're not in the range of an enemy's attack before you do. You can interrupt the animation with your dodge, but that will reduce the damage you do, obviously, and put the skill on cooldown, so it takes some skill to be precise. It's all very satisfying and stylish, even at the lower levels, and the leveling up pace is really quick, so you always get access to new skills. With me though, I got the early access with Twitch Prime, which included an XP boost for 2 weeks, and I quickly out-leveled story quests, so I couldn't say what the normal free-to-play XP rate is like. The leveling experience isn't really challenging, well, so far anyway. The dungeons are a piece of piss at the early game. At times I thought to myself, I don't really need to be here, I could just stand around picking my bum. You can even do them without having a tank and healer. In fact, you could probably do them solo, might take you a while though. Also, like I said, I outleveled the story quests, so I was breezing through them. I can imagine it gets more challenging at endgame, but personally I don't mind the easier nature of the leveling, it made me feel more powerful. But I can see it boring a fair few people. Maybe it's forgiving so you can gradually learn your class so by endgame you really know what you're doing, which is fair enough and good design in my book. Also, I wasn't playing a complex class. How do I know that? Well, when you make your character, it tells you the complexity of each class, as well as other useful information about their roles, a good idea for both beginners and veterans alike. Some of the classes are race and gender locked, which is something I have always hated. The Reaper class looked quite good fun to me, but you have to play as the pedo bait little girl race to play it, which is not something I can get immersed in really. Not all of us are weebs developers. I even like the PvP. I joined up thinking it would be the standard MMO PvP scale up your class to fit everyone else and being mostly shit, but it wasn't. I got in a game and everyone was playing as baby sumos in a League of Legends type match, and there's also one where you pilot tanks, and both of the modes are enjoyable with some decent rewards on offer. There is the typical PvP later on, but it's nice to see so many varieties of it for players who aren't super competitive or hardcore. Speaking of rewarding the player, Terra does that constantly. I was tripping over milestones and daily objectives without realising all the time, both of which reward big buckets of XP as well as currency to buy unique weapons and gear. It all went a long way to keeping me addicted. Terra is obviously free to play, and with that comes microtransactions, and I am pleased to report that I couldn't find any that took the piss price wise or pay to win wise. Yes, there are XP boosts you can buy, whether that is pay to win is up to you, but in a largely co-op game it doesn't seem to matter that much to me. Most of the stuff you can buy is cosmetic, as well as some utility stuff like bank space, mounts and the like. The port to console is pretty impressive, with some glaring performance and graphical issues. The UI and controls are really easy to navigate. They haven't just ported the PC version over and awkwardly shoved controller support into it. You can change up your hotbar and assign skills and items to it so it's optimal for you, which is a godsend because the default layout for my class was a bit clunky to control. The graphical pop-in is quite bad. The buildings, trees, NPCs all magically appear in front of you, and if you're taking one of the game's flights to another location, you can see entire villages and cities pop up as you're about 6 feet away. The lag has also been a bit of a pisser for me as well, and I'm not one who suffers with it much in other games, so take that for what it's worth. It hurts Terra more though, because its combat system system has quite an emphasis on timing, and some skills feel ping dependent. It's led me to missing attacks a few times, so it can frustrate. And the frame rate goes all over the place, causing a lot of screen tearing, and again it cocks up your attack timing. It's strange because Terra isn't really a stunner of a game, not a bad looker by any means, but I would have thought the PS4 would have an easy-ish job handling it. But they are issues that can be sorted out quite easily with patches in the future. The core of Terra though is completely sound. I will say again though, I have the elite status thing at the moment and there is no way to turn it off to see what it is like as a normal free-to-play player. So some of the conveniences it offers, like a fast travel map, may make or break the game for some people, or even me, who knows. But I would definitely recommend it. It's an MMO that I have actually enjoyed for a sustained period, unlike most, where I play for a few hours and think, wow, this is like having a second job. Wasn't Star Wars Galaxies and Phantasy Star Universe good before WoW came along and ruined everything?